We're here to demystify PoE, power over Ethernet. There just isn't one that fixes everyone's problems. You got, you know, I call standard 15 watt, PoE plus 30 watt, high PoE or PoE plus plus, that's 60, 70, 75, 90, 95 watt. Then you have AT and BT. What exactly do these mean? And how is AMG able to help our customers provide the PoE power for their devices?
Absolutely. Thanks for that. Yeah, Tom, I mean, it's been an issue. IEEE has standards. So, the first one out was the AF standard. So it's IEEE 802.3. So if you Google that, you'll find a nice chart. It gives you all the voltages and PoE levels. So generally, it's the power out of the device that's providing the power. So out of the switch or the injector, right? So AF was 15 watts. AT went up to 30. And then now, you know, as you get these power hungry domes and IR illuminators and all these IoT devices that need more power, it's gone up to BT. And BT, you know, not only, you know, is the de facto standard going forward, I believe, for most people and products, but, you know, it's up to 90 watts of power out, which is a lot of power going over that Cat 6 cable. So, and the biggest thing that I see, and we get a lot of calls, you know, PoE, basically everybody thinks it's 48 volts DC and there's a range. I think it's 44 to 50. And then, you know, each different category, AF, AT, BT. So BT, the biggest issue we have is, people have a 48 volt supply out there and now they need a 90 watt PoE. They need to go BT, but the IEEE standard is 52 volts.
Gotcha.
So that's a big educational thing we have to do as we move forward, because if you don't have an adjustable power supply, you're going to have to get one because it won't work.
The worst case scenario I know for us is our integrator goes out to do an installation and guess what? He can't power up that device, that camera, that pan, tilt, and zoom, the light, the IP speaker. All these devices now are being powered up PoE. And if you don't have the right devices, the network switch or the injector, guess what? He's sitting there now, can't power stuff up, can't program it. So it's, you got to make sure you got the right power. Back in the old analog day, you had to have that 12 volt DC, 24 volt AC, 110. Today, it's a little bit cleaner, but still, you got to make sure you have the proper devices to power that up.
Yeah, there's a lot of education that needs to happen out there. And I think, you know, what we did in the last 2 days is taking, you know, all of our different products, whether they're DC or AC powered, and try to, you know, made sure they work with all your different devices. Yep. And, you know, there's a lot of education that still needs to be had out there.
Sure.
And, I guess this is the first step there.
Well, and again, we'll post a lot of the information, and Matt does a great job with that. But also, when in doubt, contact us. Contact us at support@midchess.com. Of course, Dave at AMG, we're here to help you. Dave, thank you so much.
Thank you. It was great being here.